With that, I would like to invite Linda Vandenbrink from GeoNovum to give us an update on standards for spatial data on the web. Please.
Yes, okay. You can see my screen?
Yes, very well. I can see your screen.
Cool. Okay. So I will give a little bit of a background. First of all, I'm Linda. I work at GeoNovum in the Netherlands. GeoNovum is sort of a national standards body for geospatial standards. And I've worked there for over 10 years, so I'm really working in the standards field. Mostly, internationally, we work with the Open Geospatial Consortium. I think they had their 25th anniversary already, and their oldest standards were first published in the early 2000s, or maybe even. I'm hearing a slight echo. I think it's gone. Thank you. Okay. So they're all the standards are pretty old already. And we observed at some point, I think it was like about 6 years ago now, that we were actually in the geospatial domain very happy with our standards, and they were working pretty well. We were able to share data, to find it, and to use it. There are standardized formats for geospatial data like GML and standardized surfaces like WFS. But we started to realize that it was hard for users from outside the geospatial domain to actually find and use our data. We decided that we wanted to change that, but it seemed that the rest of the world, or sort of the wider web community, were using different standards and different ways of working than the geospatial domain was at some point. We sort of developed parallel worlds. So we decided that in order to make our data usable for the wider web community, we had to publish the spatial data on the web. Then it would be findable by search engines and usable by web developers or data users. So we in the Netherlands realized that, but there were, I think, several people around the planet who realized the same thing almost at the same time. So we had a workshop about linking geospatial data, which was organized by the OGC and the W3C together in 2014. And there was about 100 people, I think, came together and gave a lot of talks about their experiences with publishing geospatial data on the web. And a lot of ideas were tossed around, and the W3C and the OGC then decided that it was a good idea to have a joint working group. So this working group was formed. It started in 2015, and it has been going ever since in some form. At the moment, it's an interest group. But it was kind of interesting because it was the first time that W3C and OGC worked together. So they had to create what you call a memorandum of understanding. It's a sort of a legal document. I think they spent a long time getting that one right. I don't know exactly what the difficulties were, but it was not easy, I understand. But okay, it happened. And when we started the working group, we decided that we would be using W3C methods and collaboration tooling and so on. So this means that we have a GitHub repository in the W3C organization. We are using their video conferencing stuff and so on. Also their publication process and procedures for standards, but all of the standards and documents that we create have both logos from OGC and W3C, and they have copyrighted by both, I think. I don't know exactly how that works. But the good thing is that anyone who is a member of either one of the organizations can join the working group. So if you work for a company that is a member of OGC, you can join, or if you're a member of W3C, you can join. And only the chairs are a member of both organizations. And currently that's Jeremy Tandy from the Met Office and me. We are currently chairing it. And for the rest, it just works as working groups work. We have online meetings currently once a month, and if it's necessary, we have more. And we have this this rule that we try to have one face-to-face meeting at an OGC member meeting every year, and one face-to-face meeting at a W3C meeting every year. Of course, at the moment, we don't because of COVID, but we did have meetings at OGC and at W3C meetings. So the link to our GitHub is below. You can check it out and work with us also through that GitHub repository. So what did we do? When we started the working group in 2015, the goal was to integrate spatial information with other data on the web. So to make it to make spatial data part of the web of data. So that you can relate facts from different data sets to the same place and so on. And what we also did was complete the standardization of some vocabularies that were already around. And that was OWL time. That's a vocabulary that we standardized, and the sensor network ontology, SSN. And then, of course, the other big thing that we did was writing the best practices for publishing spatial data on the web. It was already mentioned by some of the other speakers. And we did some other notes as well, one about an encoding for coverage data, so gridded spatial data, coverage JSON, and a paper on publishing Earth observation data using data cubes. So the best practices, I'm pretty proud of that document. What we did was we actually gathered a lot of observations about spatial data that was already published in the wild, as we called it. But it had to be non-experimental. It had to be really production level data. And we studied the practices that were that had been used there, and selected them and wrote them down in this document. So it only, everything that we call a best practice are things that we have observed to be actually working in practice. We had a really good group working at this document. And I guess you sort of know the contents. So these are the best practices. Some of them are just general web principles. We thought we'd start with those because they are the most important ones. And then we talk about the spatial aspects. So what kind of encodings should you use? How should you publish geometries and coordinate reference systems? We had a lot of discussion about those. All kinds of things. Also, the best practice about convenience APIs is, I think, pretty interesting, talking about how to publish like easy access APIs for your spatial data. Because, well, that's already done, that document. Currently, we are So that's a procedural thing. We are an interest group, not a working group. An interest group is a group that cannot produce standards, because we finished publishing SSN and our time. So we referred to being an interest group. And we are currently doing some updates on the spatial data on the web best practice. The work is not progressing very fast at the moment, so you never know. If somebody who's listening now, if you have things that you could possibly add to the best practices to improve them even further, that would be really helpful for us. So if that's the case, just contact me or go to the GitHub and drop an issue there. We're also doing some errata for SSN and OWL time. And then we're working also on a new document, and that's a best practice around geospatial data publication and ethics. So it's called the responsible use of geospatial data, and it talks about ethical frameworks and about how you the things that you should or should not do when using location data for, I don't know, mobility use cases or things like that. You know, considerations about privacy and other things. The first version of that document has just been published, and the authors are looking for feedback on that, so that's also very welcome. Yeah, and you can see more about what we are doing at the URL. So what lies ahead is that we are rechartering as a working group. So we are going back from being an interest group to a working group, because we do have some work that we want to do on the standards that we were not allowed to do as an interest group. Those are the updates of SSN and OWL time. We're also going to finalize this best practice about geospatial and ethics. And we are going to finalize this update of the spatial data on the web best practices. And we are probably also going to produce a note about the web video map track format. And that's a way to store and to disseminate GPS tracks with video. So you can make, for example, a video using a drone, and you can embed the coordinates in that video. So, and then there's many more things that can have their podium sort of in our group, because we also have a task of identifying collaboration areas between OGC and W3C. So we are looking at possible ideas for standards if they are within the scope of web standards and also in scope of geospatial. Then they are interesting for us. So things that have already come through are, for example, MapML, which is an idea for declarative description of maps on the web. And the owner of this idea really wants maps to become a standard part of HTML. There was a joint workshop by W3C and OGC last year around this topic, and it was pretty successful. There was some interest in this, so a working group may come out of this. That would be a W3C working group that would work on this idea of really embedding maps in the HTML standards and browsers actually implementing that. Another one is CityJSON. That's an encoding for 3D city models, and that is becoming an OGC community standard. now. Another one is GeoSparkle. The idea to work on a second version was discussed in our group, and that's now happening within OGC. The web video tracks thing I already talked about. It's not yet known if that will ever be a standard. It needs more traction before it could go to the standardization track. Linked building data, that's a group at W3C who are working on an ontology about buildings, and they have been in touch with us now and then to toss ideas around and have discussions around geospatial aspects of their work. SSN version 2 is also something that we are looking at, and that would be a joint work by W3C and OGC. There's also a Web of Things at W3C. That's a set of standards for describing things on the web that you can interact with, so like sensors and actuators. They are using SSN, and they are looking at geospatial use cases at the moment and have asked for our help in identifying those. And then also there's the topic of transportation and routing. This is involving smart cars and so on, very interesting work. And the OGC is doing one part, and W3C is another part, doing another part of the work. I have some Dutch words here, sorry. So OGC is working on an API for routing. So you can ask the API for a route from point A to point B. And the W3C is more working on vehicle information sharing. So how do you get the information that the smart vehicles are gathering into the cloud? So those are just some areas that we are currently looking at or have recently looked at. And there could also always be new ideas that could be part of our, one of the things that we could look at. So if there are things that someone says, well, this is such a good idea, and it has been tried out, it works, there's a community behind it, it should be a standard, and it has to do with web and with geospatial, then you could bring it to us. That's sort of the point of this collaboration thing. That's it for me, I think. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Linda. Very good. You almost gave us the final presentation and you summed up a lot of the work. I mean, it's a very wide area of activities, and it's so much more than GeoSparkle. You know, it's so much more than a small area of interest. But let's see if there are questions in the audience, if we take some questions from our participants.
Hi, Marcus, this is Monica again.
Very good.
Hi, Linda. Thanks for the presentation. I have a question on gridded data. So you mentioned briefly that you've worked on some standards for gridded data or some ontologies and some data models.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, if you could point me to those, that would be great, because we are looking for such a thing.
Okay, yeah, I can look that up for you and put it in the chat.
Thank you. And is it so common for gridded data to be exposed on the web? Are many people asking for it?
Yeah, I think it's pretty common, yes. And there have been OGC standards for doing that. They have been around for a long time, but they are pretty complex and targeted towards real experts.
Yeah, and is it just so do you apart from representing the data itself, do you also have standards for metadata around the gridded data? So for example, the resolution, the various provenance related information about the authority who provides the gridded data, so on and so forth. I mean, of course, I could always use DCAT. I could always fall back on DCAT for those sort of provenance-related information. But I was wondering if there is something that goes hand in hand specifically for gridded data.
Not specifically for gridded data, but there is a very extensive metadata standard for geospatial data, and it's an ISO standard.
Yeah, I know about
that. Yeah, the ISO 19115. Yeah. So that's what's always used in this domain.
Okay, and along with the link, if you know of any examples, use cases, which have been published, and if you could put a pointer to those as well, that would be very, very helpful. Thank you.
Use cases for gridded data?
Yes.
Okay.
And representation of it as link data.
Yeah, okay. I'm pasting some links in the chat for you.
Yeah, do you put in the Zoom chat or in the Gitter?
I'm only in the Zoom chat.
Yeah, okay. Put them in the Zoom
chat. Okay.
Actually, while you do that, I will go off the record now.